Central Trojans. My name is Dakota Hayden. And as we get things started off here with the kickoff, and after that kickoff, Comets are right set up on the 39-yard line. Get ready to push for the offensive. Here we go, run by number 12. 21, my bad. Efren Amasquita down on about the 45-yard line. Second down with 3 yards to go for the Comets. It looked like they were trying to get a quarterback sneak in there to get some yard coverage. Just crossed the 50-yard line. And that'll set it first down for Comets. It seemed like they were going to try and do a handoff play right there to Casey, number 40. Didn't turn out so well, got stopped by the Trojans. Let's see what the Comets can pull out their sleeve this time around. Fake handoff. And number 35, Colton Walker, stopped right on about the 51 yard line.
Lots of two on the play. It'll be third and 11 for Caston.
Oh, looks like I was wrong. That's going to be sitting on the 49 yard line. Number 20, Brady Hartman, tried to do another handoff play. It seems like he got stopped to lose a few yards there. Here we go, Hartman passing off. I don't think that pass was complete. No, pass was incomplete. That'll make it a turnover on downs, and West Central Trojans gain the ball. First and 10. West Central starts to run through and get stopped by the Comets, although they did gain a few yards. A great crowd turnout tonight for both Comets and Central. Plenty of people here to fill the stands. There's only one set of bleachers here at West Central Trojans, for the West Central Trojans set up here. I'm starting to repeat myself. You catch that?
Go
And it looks like the Trojans tried to go through another run, stopped again by the Comets. And if any of you viewers out there are wondering where my co-commentator is, he's not sick or hurt or anything. He's doing just fine. We just had a lack of equipment going here to this away game. And we told him to go ahead and take the day off. So to my co-commentator, Galen, hope you're getting rest and relaxed since we gave you the day off there, buddy.
17 class hands off to number one, Colin Tripp, the thrust down by Comets, number 44, Zach Zolkum. But that will be enough for a Trojan first down.
From that last play, Trojans just got enough yards to make it to a first down. Here we go, setting up for again. Pass.
Brady Clutton's pass is broken out by Comets number 20, Brady Hartman.
Brady Hartman interrupted that pass and ended up breaking that one. Trojans stay right where they are. Flag called by the refs.
Delay a game on the Trojans. It will be 5-yard penalty, second and 15.
Putting a 5-yard penalty on the Trojans for delaying of play. Delaying of game. Delay of game, I've been told. I apologize, I'm still new to all this. Pass play by the Trojans, interrupted, not intercepted. I was about ready to say that.
Clutch's pass, intended for West Central, number 2, Kirkland the Strong, is incomplete. It'll be 3rd and 15 for West Central.
3rd down, 15 yards to go for West Central. So far, Comets have been able to hold them back for now, just starting off here. Be interesting to see what turns around as this game progresses tonight. And it is a lovely night for a game. A few clouds around. So far, pretty clear skies. A little chilly out, but it should be fine as the night progresses. And there was a scramble out there. I had no idea what happened right there. I think that was a handoff. Yep. They kind of did a little circle going around there. Setting up for the next play. 4th down and 10 to go for the Trojans. Pass play reaches nobody. Comets retain turnover on downs.
Is incomplete. That'll be turnover on downs for the Trojans. 1st and 10 for the Comets at their own 40-yard line.
Comets set up to take up the offensive here. Hopefully they can go for a touchdown, get enough yards to get over there. Hand off to Efren. And is pushed out of bounds.
Hartman hands off to Amasina. Dropped down
McCone. He has 5 yard carry on the play. Second and 10. Second and 5, excuse me, for the Comets.
Ball's going to be resting about on the 45-yard line, making it 5 yards to go for the Comets as we approach second down. Handoff to number 35, Colton Walker, and he stopped. That's going to be a loss of yards.
Loss of 4 on the play. It'll be 3rd and 9 for the Comets.
The Comets stuck 3rd down with 9 yards to go. Need to make a push play here to get to that 1st down. It looked like they tried to do the QB sneak, maybe. No, that was a handoff. Handoff play. Stopped at the 48-yard line. It looks like that is going to end up being first down for Comets.
Short gain on the play results in a first down for Caston.
It's like whatever they did was just enough to get them the yards they needed to get that first down. Handoff. And got destroyed by the Trojans' defenses. Dogpile.
Hartman hands off to number 35, Colton Welker. Brought down by Trojan 50, Justin Bushman. Gained a few on the play.
However, that did give him 2 yards, so as we approach the second down, they've got at least some coverage there. Not a lot. I wasn't even paying attention that play, but I think it was a handoff. Couldn't see who to, though. That's going to be to number 40, Casey Ault, who in the past has made some really great running plays. If he can get some of those plays in tonight and gain a lot of yards for us, then we're in for a good night tonight. Fake handoff by Brady. Pass, I think, intended for number 40, Casey, but didn't reach his target. Bit of an overshot. Fourth down for the Comets with 8 yards to go. A little bit of a struggle here on the 48-yard line. And we're reaching about the 4-minute mark for the first quarter. Plenty of time for something cool to happen here. Comets kick the ball off.
North Central will set up shop at their own 17-yard line. First and 10 for the Trojans.
Trojans are going to set up shop on the 17-yard line. First and 10 to go. Thank you. Trojans with the handoff play. Stopped. We did get a pretty decent gainage on yards for the Trojans. Only 4 yards to go for the second down. Ball resting on 24-yard line. Pass by Trojans, incomplete. Just slipped right out of his grasp. Third and four for the Trojans. Still resting on the 24-yard line. So far, Commons have been able to hold them back. Hand off by the Trojans. And he is gaining. Now it looked like it would be first down for Trojans. A pretty good play call by the Trojans, I'll be honest. About 3 minutes to go on the first quarter. Comet's got to try and retain that ball back. Here we go. Handoff play stopped by the Comets. If they can just keep the Trojans pushed back, we should be pretty good set up to get a turnover on downs. Casey Ault was able to put the down to the Trojans runner for that play. Trojans with another handoff play. No ground. Gainage of yards there. Four yards to go for the third down on the Trojans. Comets defense holding up, but Trojans keep gaining yards every play. Could stir up trouble here. Pass play by Trojans. Intercepted by number 53. Number 53, Trent Howard with the interception. Get in the comments to retain the ball on let's see. Is that the 29-yard line? Yes, I do believe. It looked like Brady was going for a pass, but stopped. Under 2 minutes left to go for the first quarter.
Brady Armin is brought down in the backfield by West Central's number 54, Chris Ames. It'll be second and 11 for the Comets.
Looked to be a handoff. Yep, handoff play. A very brutal combination of Hartman and Casey with the handoffs to gain yards, but so far the Trojans have been able to keep that shut down. It's still the first quarter though. We have yet to see if they can keep that up. And under 30 seconds here for the first quarter, and it's about ready to come to an end. Another handoff. Number 40, Casey All got flipped over a Trojan defender. The handoff was sent to number 21, Efren, but he got brought down. And it looks like that's going to end it for the first quarter. I'll be right back with you guys after the break. All right, and we're back for the second quarter. Caston with the ball. Score so far tied at nothing. And handoff to number 21, Efren, stopped at about roughly the 25-yard line. It looks like I didn't catch. West Central ended up receiving the ball on that one. It was a turnover. It was a handoff by West Central. Stopped at, I'd about say, 29-yard line. Casey Alt with that tackle.
3-yard gain on the play, second and seven for West Central.
West Central, second down with about 7 yards to go. I got faith in the Comet defense to be able to hold them back. Handoff by the Trojans. Flag on the field. Even with the flag, still Colton Walker, number 35, just annihilated Trojans offensive player, taking out his leg completely. A 10-yard penalty on West Central. And that is going to suit as an advantage for the Comets. Trojans second down, 20 yards to go. Trojans went with a handoff. And that'll set the Trojans for their third down, still on the 15-yard line.
Third and 20 for West Central.
And plenty of encouragement tonight from both teams. Not only do we got a full crowd up here in the stands, but we got cheerleaders supporting both teams, trying to get them to pull out a win tonight. Trojans looking for a pass play, and it is complete. That'll be first down for the Trojans.
Number 30, Logan Sharp.
I'll admit that that was a really nice clutch play by the Trojans. The Comets got to pull something out of their hat here to be able to keep them back. Pass, and he's stopped. Put it for their second down, 12 yards to go for the Trojans. Ball resting on the 34-yard line, I do believe. And here we go, handoff play by the Trojans. And he's stopped down. About 39-yard line. That'll put the Trojans third down with about 7 yards to go. Handoff play again by the Trojans. He's a bit open there. Number 21, Efren, stopping him.
Clutch hands off to West Central's number one, Colin Fritz, brought down by Caston's number 21, Amasita.
That was a nice stop by Efren.
3 yard gain on the play. It'll be fourth and four for the Trojans.
Trojans, 4 yards to go on their fourth down. Comets in a good position to keep them stopped here to retain the ball for the offensive. Kickoff by the Trojans. And it's going to sit all the way down there on the 23-yard line. First and 10 for the Comets. Just about 8 minutes to go on our second quarter. Comets taking the offensive. Like handoff. I couldn't see who that handoff was to.
Harmon hands off to number 40, Casey Ault.
And that was to number 40, Casey Ault. Was able to gain some yards there. Second and four for Comets. Ball sitting on the 30-yard line. It looks like refs are calling a timeout. Thank you again for tuning in to RTC TV. I'll be right back with you after the break.
You know, honestly, yeah. I go off when timeouts are called. You know, Chris would have found out anyway if I didn't say anything. Because if Chris went through the editing, he'd be like, why do I only hear one voice? Oh, someone wasn't there. Who wasn't there? Let me talk to this guy. What happened?
Yeah. And here we go, getting started right back up again. If you're just tuning in with us, my name's Dakota Hayden, and I will be your solo host in the game tonight between the West Central Trojans and the Caston Comets. It looked like a handoff play. To number 52, Phoenix Singleton. Comets been able to successfully gain some yards on these handoffs, but the Trojans have done a pretty decent job on the defensive. Let's see if the Comets could find a bit of a loophole in their defenses and split out for a major yard gainage. Another handoff to number was that? Again to Phoenix Singleton. And it looked like it was a loss of yards that put them back on the five yards to go on the 30-yard line. Phoenix Singleton kicking off the ball. The Trojans to retain. The Trojans screwed up. Now, I'm no expert. I think that was a recovery on the Comets. So I think that would mean that Comets get the ball. And would you look at that, I'm right for once. Ball on the 46-yard line, Comets, first and 10. Hand off to number 40, Casey out in the open. He's dropped on about 40-yard line. And that's what I was talking about on that Brady and Casey combination there for the handoff plays. Major gainage of yards, those two. All right, we got another timeout called by West Central. I'll be back with you guys after this little break.
There's no way my mom would take my spot. Alright, I gotta start back up.
Yep. And we're back. Caston first and 10. Score still tied at absolutely nothing. Ball sitting on the 41-yard line. And we got about roughly 5 minutes and 30 seconds left on the second quarter. And it looked like that Hartman was going for number 20. Brady Hartman was going for another handoff to Casey. Stopped, but with a gain of a yard. A yard or two, maybe. Math was never my best subject. Comets setting up here. Handoff to number 35, Colton Welker. And he's stopped on the 35-yard line about. Decent gains of yards. Comets third down with 3 yards to go. Just enough yards on the third down to be able to, should be able to make it before the fourth. We'll just have to see what they decide to play here. And I'm going to predict another handoff. Oh, I was right. To number 21, Ephron. And Ephron gains just enough yards for the first down. He stumbles, but he's fine.
Harmon hands off to number 21, Brought down by West.
Once again, first down for Comets. Resting on the 26-yard line. With roughly 4 minutes to go for the second quarter. All right, we're looking at some decent grounds here to score some points. Handoff again. Brought down. I don't think there was a gainage or a loss there. Ooh, looks like somebody's got better vision than I do. There was a gain of 1 yard, a major 1 yard on that play. Under pass play by number 20, Brady. Almost intercepted by the Trojans. Pass looked like to be going for, is that number 21, Ephron? Yep, that's number 21, Ephron. Third down with 9 yards to go for Caston. A pass play, pretty rare for the Caston, for the Comets offensive. Usually they're running handoffs and run plays, but the pass is pretty rare. Occasionally, though, they can get it down. But hopefully we can get it going for us in this game. And a slight delay in gameplay as both teams are figuring out what to do. And still, here we go, Comets handoff. Number 40, Casey, was met and got received by, let me try that sentence again. Brady Hartman handed off the ball to Casey Ault. He got dropped down at about the 24-yard line. 7 yards to go, fourth down for Comets. I'd say the best bet for the Comets here to just be to go ahead and kick it off to him. Unless they're thinking risky and could hand it off to Casey again for a gainage of yards. We'll see what is up. And it looks like another timeout called by Caston. I'll be right back with you after this little break.
something else after that. Like when I said, they usually run like handoffs. No, I said occasionally in the past, but it's pretty rare. It's true. Everybody knows that. Who doesn't know that? Yeah.
All right, and we're back with about 2 minutes and 30 seconds to go for the second quarter. Comets still got the ball for their fourth down with 7 yards to go. A pretty low-scoring game tonight, at tied both teams at zero. A pass made by Brady to number, which number is that? That was to number seven, Tate. And that made plenty of yards to get him for a first down. That was awesome. Comets all set up to be the first team to score here tonight. Here we go, handoff to number 40, Casey. And if you can't tell by the screeches of the crowd, Casey was able to make the yards for a touchdown for Comets. Comets take the lead 6-0. I think the Comets are going to kick it. No. A handoff caught by, not a handoff, a pass caught by Colton Walker, number 35. But I think the refs are calling him out. It looked fine to me, but I guess the refs say otherwise. So I guess Trojans retain. The Comets will be taking up the defensive. Quite a nice, beautiful evening as the sun's starting to set today, or tonight, I should say. Wind's not blowing too hard, as I can tell by this giant windmill station just off the side of the field. Moving at a pretty nice pace there, adding a nice calm environment to this intense football game that we're watching here tonight. Here we are set up for the Comets to kick it off to the Trojans. And the kick is caught. And Comets bring him down. The Trojans are all set up on about the 34-yard line, I'd say roughly. 34, 33. 34-yard line, as the official will call it. That'll set them up for the offensive, and the Comets on the defensive. With less than 2 minutes here at the second quarter. Handoff by the Trojans. And he is cornered, running around. And the Trojan just barely escaping the grasp of number 52, but taken down by number 21, Efren Amoskita.
number 7, Ed Cowell. Ross the
Van
on the play will be second.
Oh, that might have been my bad. That might have been number 7 on that one. I got to apologize, folks. At this vantage point that I'm at, it's kind of hard to see some of these plays. But that'll set the Trojans up on their second down with 18 yards to go. And I think 27-yard line. Looking for a pass. Nope, he changed his mind. Stopped down by the Comets.
Clinton's QB run is brought down by Caston number 58, John Mitchell.
Here we go. Calling another timeout. And I'll be back with you folks right after this break.
I can't provide my own color. I can't bounce off of myself. I want food.
All right, and we're back. Trojans taking on the offensive here. 17 yards to go. And pass play. Pass play to a handoff. It's a major gainage of yardage for the Trojans. Flags thrown. I don't know what the ref's calling for the flag for here. That's going to be a personal foul against the Comets. And that's going to put Trojans at a first down. Not good for the Comets. But with a little over 30 seconds to go for the second quarter, I wouldn't sweat it too much. Pass by Trojans. Caught. Ooh! And he gets destroyed by number 35, Colton Welker. And another timeout called. I'll be back with you guys after this break. A lot of timeouts being called this time. All right, and we're back and rolling with exactly 29.3 seconds left to go. Trojans with only 5 yards to go on their second down. Ball's resting on the 30-yard line. And looks like they were looking for a pass. And he's stopped by number 44, Zach Slocum.
Timeout, West Central.
And another timeout called by West Central. I'll be back with you guys after this break.
Oh, I'm live. Caston Dynamites. Jalapeno cheese is good, though.
Yeah, it is.
It's all right. It's cool, dude.
All right, and we're getting set up again here with 20.8 seconds left to go on the clock. Caston still leading 6-0. Trojans must be getting a little bit nervous calling these timeouts. Here we go, looking for a pass. And it's incomplete. It looked to be incomplete. Let's see what the ref calls. Yes, incomplete.
It'll be fourth and 8 for West Central.
8 yards to go. Fourth down for West Central. Comets doing a great job holding them back here. And I'll be honest, this has been the longest second quarter of my life. Looking for another pass play. Ball's thrown. Ball's almost intercepted by number 35, Colton Walker. He's real close. And that'll set up a turnover on downs. Comets will be taking the offensive here. Which honestly, at this point, I don't see why we should do anything with 6.9 seconds left on the clock. But we'll see what we're going to do with that. And Comets are just going to let the clock run out. And that's going to end it for the second quarter. Thank you all again for tuning in to RTC TV. We'll be right back with you for the third quarter. And welcome back again to RTC TV. In case you forgot, my name's Dakota Hayden, and we just got finished up with halftime here, moving on to the third quarter. Caston in the lead, 6-0, as we get up started here.
Why are you talking to that?
And Comets getting set up to kick off the ball to the Trojans here.
Number 66, Roger Flint, set to kick for Caston.
And Caston has appointed number 66, Roger Flint, to perform the kickoff for Caston. Roger Flint, I've been told, has had some pretty good kicks in practice. But that, well, I'm not so sure what that was. Flag called by the refs. Now we're officially setting up here to actually see what Roger can do as he takes the kicking position for the Comets to kick off the ball to the Trojans. Right, let's see how much practice Roger's gotten in here for these kicks. He kicks the ball. Pretty good kick by Roger. Ooh. Wasn't able to get too much ground on that one. Trojans taken down at about the 20-yard line. And here the Trojans will take the offensive and attempt to break through the Comets' defense. Handoff play by the Trojans. Stopped on roughly the 21-yard line. It looks like that play was stopped by number 53, Trenton Howard. That might have been wrong. They might not have gained any yards on that play. Trojans evading the Comets' defense, and he's brought down. Loss of yards for the Trojans. That'll make it third down for the Trojans. With 16 yards to go. Trojans seeming to look for it to make a pass. He throws. Pass is incomplete. At number 7, Tate. On number 52, my bad. To stop that pass. No, I was right on number 7.
Back to kick for the Trojans, number 22, Cameron Perez.
I don't know.
Casey Alt back deep to receive the kick for the Comets.
Trojans kick the ball back off to the Comets. And they're going to place it right at about 43-yard line. Or 41, I mean, I was only two off. Math was never my best subject, as stated before, but I try. The Comets take the offensive here with we're getting to about 10 minutes left in the third quarter. Flag called by ref. It looks like penalty's going to be on the Comets, pushing him back 5 yards. False start.
5-yard penalty, first and 15 for the Comets.
And that's not going to be good for us here. Comets handoff play, handoff to number 40, Casey. Stopped on the 45-yard line. Comets reaching their second down with still 15 yards to go. We got to pull off a big move here to get that yard gainage back. Looks like Brady's running for it, and he gains the yards back. Nice play by number 20, Brady Hartman, just running through the ranks. I think that was just enough yard coverage for maybe. Ooh. We got a player down for the Trojans back on the 40-yard line. There's going to be a hold on that play. Can't tell from here, but it seems to look pretty bad. Looks to be about on his, maybe near his ankle. It's muted now, Kyle. Wouldn't it be fun to just sit up there, though, while it's spinning? Just laying down, shooting the breeze. Maybe a cottontail, you know? Oh, yeah. That'd be fun. Sure test of strength. It looks like he seems to be doing just fine, hobbling on off the field there. That's good. It never is a good thing to see a player get injured on the field. But a good show of sportsmanship here by the crowd today. All right, now with that taken care of, we get put for the first and 10 of the Comets. It was enough yards by Brady to make it for the first down. The ball's resting on the 23-yard line. Handoff. Brought down.
Hartman hands off to number 40, Casey Halt. Gain of 3 on the play, 2nd and 7 for the Comets.
Comets doing a decent job gaining small portions of yards here, but every little bit counts here, going to score another touchdown. Handoff to number 21, Efren. He's brought down. And Efren was able to pull it far enough to make it for a first down. Ball rested on the 11-yard line. 1st and 10 for the Comets. Hand off to number 40, Casey Ault. He's wide open and makes it for a touchdown. Touchdown, Comets. And number 40, Casey Ault. Casey completely scorching the Trojans defense. Excellent play by the Comets. That'll put them up 12-0. Comets go. Brady rushing in. Flag called on the play. But Brady did make it to the end zone. It seemed. Looks like we got another injury for the Trojans. It looks like he's getting up. Must have been just a bad hit around on his thigh area. Trojans taking some heat tonight, but they're all getting back up. Shows how much fight they got and how much of a challenge they're going to be for us. But we seem to be keeping them under control with a good 12-0 lead.
He said he might not be able to play next year.
Yeah. No, I don't understand that because I like Calvin's playing.
Oh, I know. Calvin was, what, 20?
Mm-hmm.
22, yeah.
Here the Comets. It's enough Brady looking for a pass to 21 Efren. He's down.
No good.
To a no good on the 3-point conversion. That was a good try, though. Now Trojans going to retain the ball and take the offensive, putting the Comets on the defensive. Ball is going to get placed on the 40-yard line.
My phone switches on that.
So is mine.
It should be. It's 825 right here. Yeah, 825, so it's got to be 930.
I'm waving from my phone.
Muster is power.
Should we follow you?
I don't know. We'll find out.
Oh, wait, silly me. Who knows where the ball's going to get placed right now? We haven't kicked it off to him yet. Huh. Calling the shots before they actually happen. Look at me go. I think they're appointing number 66, Roger Flint, again, to handle the kick for the Comets. Ooh, and it looks like there's a bit of aggression between the Trojans and the Comets up there. Broken up by the refs, though. No doubt there is a little tension in between these two teams.
Can you do a rewind over here? Can you do a rewind for that?
And West Central is going to drop on the 49-yard line.
Wait, where does this boat go?
It goes to RTC, then they edit it, put it on TV. And on the computer, yeah. Oh, they'll put it in there. Everyone loves a good fight. Trojan setting up on the offensive here. Handoff. And stopped by number 53, Trenton Howard, and number 8, Blake Albright. That'll put the Trojans for their second down with 8 yards to go on about, I'd say, 49-yard line. Let's go! Another handoff play by the Trojans. Stopped again. Maybe a 1 or 2 yard gain. Flag's called by the ref. Looks like there seems to be a fight breaking out there. Again, like I said before, a little bit of tension in between the two teams.
Wait, is that still on? Are they going to shoot the tape? Or are they like trying to fight 72? I want to replay this.
Here we go, setting up again. Once again, second down for the Trojans. 8 yards to go. Oh, they're getting pushed back. It looks like they're calling the Trojans the initiators of that little rumble that they had going on there. So set them on the 39-yard line. And third down for him. No, second down. I can't count. Pass by the Trojans. Intercepted by number 20, Brady Hartman, for a full run for another touchdown, Comets. Flag thrown out on the field. But I don't think it matters. This crowd doesn't care, especially Comet supporters. Excellent interception by number 20, Brady Hartman.
Brandon Cuss's pass is intercepted by Comet's number 20, Brady Hartman. They return for a touchdown.
That's going to put the score 18-0. Comets taking a really high lead. And the flag that was placed earlier was going to be put as a personal foul against the Trojans, which is definitely going to help if the Comets are going to go for a 3-point conversion. I'm sorry, 2-point conversion. Handoff. And it counts. 2-point conversion made by the Comets. Put them up 20-0. Comets scoring a rocking lead of 20-0 with a little bit over 7 minutes left on the clock for the third quarter. And the crowd out here getting all riled up for the Comets. There we go, getting set up again. Comet's going to kick off the ball again to the Trojans.
Coming on the kick for the Comets, number 66, Roger Flint.
And Caston pointing number 66 again for the kick. Oh! And a rough hit up there. see who that hit was on. Regardless, that was a tough one. West Central will be taking the ball and placing it on the 46-yard line. First and 10 for the Trojans. Going for a pass. Pass is complete. Taken down on the 46, 47, I'd say, yard line. Had to put it for second and nine. Sorry, for the Trojans. Trojans going up here again for the offense. Hand off. He's spotted and taken down by number 20, Brady Hartman, and it looks to be number 53, Trenton Howard, on that takedown.
Dude, dang straight, that's what I do. Just sit out there and watch. Yeah, it's short.
It'll be third and nine for the Trojans.
Trojans, no yard gain on that last play. Stuck at 9 yards to go for third down. Handoff. Oh, fake handoff to a pass. Juked me out. Almost intercepted by Colton Walker. Flag was called on the play. Against the Trojans, moving them back. About 5 yards. The penalty is being called for holding. So that'll serve as an advantage for the Comets, and of course a disadvantage for the Trojans, obviously. Trojans kick the ball back off to the Comets. About 6 minutes left to go on the clock for the third quarter. Caston's going to set the ball down on the 32-yard line for first and 10. And the crowd is all riled up here tonight for the Comets for them to take a really big lead so the Trojans cannot make a comeback. Hand off to number 40, Casey Ault, to gain some yards. But they're putting a flag against the Comets. A flag for holding to put them on a 10-yard penalty. It looks like a timeout's going to be called, and we'll get right back to you after this break. Thank you again for tuning in to RTC TV.
Say that, Kyle.
I mean, I didn't show up.
Yeah, you did not show up for a while there. That might have done something.
My golf club on my porch.
Yeah. for an injury? Oh.
And we're back, ladies and gentlemen. It seemed to have been an injury timeout, and the player seems to have been just fine getting off the field. And they're going to place the ball down on the 17-yard line. Suffered the yard loss to put us at 25 yards to go for the Comets. As we approach about 5 minutes and roughly 40 seconds left on the third quarter. Handoff play to number 21, Ephraim Amaskina. He's wide open. All the yards gained. Put down on about the 42-yard line. Excellent play by the Comets. Definite first down. Apologies, it was on the 49-yard line. I overshot it a bit. I'm setting up handoff. Handoff. He's wide open. Casey. Casey seemed to have been jumbling the ball in his hand there for a little bit there. And I think the Comets recovered it. We couldn't tell who it was recovered by, but I think the Comets got it. Yeah, 2-2. That was a close one right there. There was a lot of Trojan kids swarming Casey as he started letting go of that ball. I'm setting up here. Another handoff. And is down on about the 44-yard line. And that'll be third down for the Comets with about 1 yard to go for the first down. With about 4 minutes and 30 seconds left on the clock for this third quarter. Comets are able to gain enough yards for a first down. Brady Hartman decided to try and sneak through the Trojans. And was able to get that yard and make it a first down for the Comets. The Comets go. To get a little bit of yard gainage for a quarterback run. Second down for Comets, 5 yards to go. Ball's about on the 33-yard line. And Comets in prime advancing position to put them way ahead of the Trojans here tonight. Handoff to number 52, Phoenix Singleton. He's pushed out by the Trojan defenders.
Hartman hands off to number 52, Phoenix Singleton. Knocked out by number 34, Ethan White.
And as the sun finally goes down tonight, the lights start kicking on and the bugs start coming out. I see a lot of crowd members out here swatting their faces trying to get rid of the little pests. Including myself. Hey, Comets setting up third down, 3 yards to go. Handoff. Brought down on about the 26, 27 yard line. The classic tag team action of Brady Hart and Casey Ault. That should have been enough yards for a first down for the Comets.
Oh, he is. Your mom is just like a party pooper.
Got 2 minutes and 30 seconds left to go here for the third quarter. Hand off to Casey Ault, number 40. And that'll gain some yards for the Comets. Second down for the Comets. About 4 yards to go. Comets just roaring on the offensive here tonight. Fake handoff by Brady. Was spotted by the Trojans, and that's going to be a loss of yards. That's going to put a gain of 3 yards for 7 yards to go for the third down on Comets. Comets got to think of a new strategy here. You know, Brady just got swarmed by the Trojan defenders. Another loss of yards. Not looking too good here. And that's going to put it 4-17 for the Comets.
It'll be 4th and 17 for the Comets.
Then we got about 30 seconds left to go here for the third quarter. Comets still leading 20-0. And a timeout is called, and I'm going to take a short break here. I'll be right back with you guys after the timeout.
I bet they got a t-shirt here. Yeah, we don't use it. Yeah, that's how I got, remember when Graham Redwick, yeah, did the wrestling thing? I got one of his shirts. Yeah, shot it off the can, just like, yes. Of course, when he did that, I was like fat and stubby, but now I can wear it just fine. But why would I? Nobody remembers that.
All right, and we're back after the timeout. Comets 4-17. Get it back off to the Trojans. The flag called on by the ref. What was the flag for?
Central. 20. You have a turn? lost my clipper.
I think they went through some kind of ball exchange out there on the field. And West Central will retain, taking the offensive on the 25-yard line. First and 10 with about 23 seconds left on the clock.
If it will work in the car, though.
Hand off by the Trojans. Stop by number 7, Tate Cowell.
Last hands off to West Central number 1, Colin Fritz, is brought down by Comet number 7, Tate Cowell on the plate.
That was hurrying up, Owen, dude. I didn't even want to push my down, COVID, you know?
I wouldn't even want to push my down. That is the end.
And that's going to end it for the third quarter. Once again, thank you all for watching RTC TV, and I will be right back with you for the fourth and final quarter of tonight's game. And we are back with the fourth quarter. Completely caught me off guard. There's a handoff on the play of the Trojans. And if you're just joining us late, starting off in the fourth quarter, Comets up by 20, Trojans 0. Trojans on the offensive. But third down with 9 yards to go on the 27-yard line. Comets so far have been successful to hold them back as if they haven't scored a point yet. Pass by the Trojans. I think that was a complete pass on the Trojans. Nope, calling it incomplete. It knocked out of his hands just before it reached full control. Full possession would be a better word for that.
Number 3, Logan Stark, set to kick off for the Trojans.
And Trojans fiddling with the ball, kick off to the Comets. There's a flag being called on the play. Words are scrambling. Must be getting tired. It's going to be a penalty against the Trojans as Comets take the offensive here. First and 10 on the 27-yard line. Nope, 36. 36. Other side. The Comets set up pretty decently here to make another touchdown to put them way ahead of the Trojans. Handoff to number 21, Ephron. Gained some yards there, puts them about 38, 39 yard line. I'm calling 38. Comets got 7 yards to go on the second down. Comets handoff to number 35, Colton Walker, taken down. Seems like Trojans defense is trying to start up and kick in to try and hold the Comets back. I mean, a loss is a loss, but depending on the points, depends on how bad the loss is.
Not me.
Now it's set up for another handoff to Efren. And Efren finally gonna take it down. Flag on the play. Holding on the Comets. The penalty goes.
The penalty is declined.
The penalty has been declined, making it fourth down for the Comets. About 9 yards to go. The Comets have placed number 52, Phoenix, to punt it back off to the Trojans. Number 52 with a really nice kick there. That'll set up the Trojans about the 34 yard line. Man, I keep looking on the wrong side here. Set up on the 34 yard line. About 9 minutes left to go on the clock for this fourth quarter. Handoff play. Comets bringing him down. That's going to be a loss of yards on the Trojans' part. Nice defense by the Comets. Comets definitely showing much better performance on their defense than they did last week. Flag was put down on the play. I think it was for maybe a slight injury. Hard to tell.
Yeah, you really do. For your mom? In the morning?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. He calls you every morning, yo. He's kind of getting on your nerves, kind of.
I'm supposed to call me today. That car didn't have all its headlights.
And the Trojan is back up and running. A lot of injuries happened for the Trojans tonight, but thankfully they've all been able to get back up and running again here tonight. Here we get back going again. Comets still taking on the offensive on the. Trojans taking on the offense about the 27 yard line, second and 17. Handoff, Trojan wide open. Looks like he might have fumbled, but it might have. I think it was recovered. Regardless, ends up being 5 yards to go for the Trojans on the third down, resting on the 40-yard line. Trojans starting to spark up a fight here. Comets really need to stomp out this fire. And they do by pushing them back a few yards. So you need to push them back about 3 yards, making it 4-8 for the Trojans. It looks like the Trojans are setting up to punt it back off to the Comets. And yes, they are indeed so. Decent punt by the Trojans. Caught by Blake Albright, number 8. Planted down on the 28th yard line, 29th yard line, maybe even 30.
Huh?
30 yard line it is. Comets retained for the offensive, 1st and 10. Still skyrocketing from their lead of 20 to nothing. Now it's handoff. Looks like that handoff went to number 52, Phoenix Singleton. Phoenix making progress and gaining some yards for the Comets here, making it 2nd and 5. Ball firmly resting on the 35-yard line, handed off to Phoenix again. Major gains of grounds. Nice play by the Comets and nice run by number 52, Phoenix Singleton. That should be 1st down for Comets. And it is indeed 1st down for the Comets. Ball resting on the 43-yard line with about 6 minutes left to go on the clock for the 4th quarter. Handoff to number 8, Blake Albright. Comets running game definitely pulling off in gainage of some yards here. Starting to efficiently break through the Trojans' defense line. Putting the ball down on the 49-yard line with 4 yards to go for the 2nd down on the Comets. Handoff again. He's taken down. Blake Albright was able to gain a yard on that, making it 3rd and 3 for the Comets. Slowly but surely, Comets etching their way up to a 1st down. Handoff again to number 21, Efren. And a flag has been called on the play. And the Comets are going to get flagged with holding. This isn't going to set too well for us. Pushing us back about 5 yards. Oh, I lied. 10 yards. Still getting used to this penalty distribution here.
3rd and 12 for the
Comets. Put the Comets back with 12 yards to go for the 3rd down. 41-yard line, they're sitting nice and pretty. I have full confidence they can make back this yards, but let's see what they can do here. Hand off to number 52. Phoenix is stopped at the, looks like the 41-yard line. No gainage. It looks like the it looks like the Comets are setting up to punt it back off here to the Trojans as we get around 4 minutes left on the fourth quarter. Comets still in the lead, 20-0. Nice punt by number 52, Phoenix Singleton. It's picked up by the Trojan. And he gains yards. He's finally pushed out by number 53, Trenton Howard, at number 60 for the Comets. It looks like the refs threw a flag on the play. And they're putting the flag on against the Comets. But it got declined. So we're all good and set. For the Trojans to take on the offensive, first and 10 on the 45-yard line. Well, the Comets take up the defense again as we reach about 3 minutes and 30 seconds left on the clock here for our final quarter. Starting off again, handoff play by Trojans. Caught by number 53, Trenton Howard, and put down. But still a gainage on yards, putting him at second and eight. I mean, I've seen ridiculous things happen before, but I don't think there's any way the Trojans can be able to come back here with 3 minutes remaining on the clock in the fourth quarter. But I'm not going to count my turkeys before they hatch just yet here.
West Central Stadium, a heads-off to number two, Kirkland Bashan.
Oh, that battery's about ready to die.
That's going to be a yard gainage for the Trojans, putting them at 3 and 4. 4 yards to go on the third down to interpret. Setting them on the 37-yard line. Ooh. Handoff is fumbled by the Trojans. And recovered by the Comets. A nice play by Roger, number 66, to recover that fumble. Putting Comets back on the offensive here at 2 minutes left on the fourth quarter. And I got a hunch that I'm going to go ahead and call it that the Comets definitely got this game all wrapped up here. Caston's going to call a timeout, and I will be right back with you guys right after this break. Thank you again for tuning in to RTC TV.
It's 9 o'clock. Ah. I cry every time.
And here we go, getting started again as we're nearing the end of the fourth quarter. The Comets up 20-0. The Comets take the offensive. Handoff play to Phoenix. Number 52.
Number 12, Zach Conrad, hands off to number 5, Lonnie Nice.
Ooh, my bad. I thought I saw 52, but it turns out it was just number 5. But it was a gain of 2 yards, so that definitely helps for the Comets. But at this point, they don't really need too much else, standing 20-0. But the more points, the better. Hand off to number 52, Phoenix. It's taken down by the Trojans. And number 12, Zach Conrad, seems to have taken over the quarterback position for the Comets. Number 20, Brady must have had enough and decided to take a little break. But good for Conrad to get some plays in here as quarterback. We got a minute left in the fourth quarter. This Comets third down with 11 yards to go at the 43-yard line. Handoff. Number 52, Phoenix Singleton, has got put down.
Conrad hands off to number 52, Phoenix Singleton, hit by a swarm of Trojan defenders. It'll be fourth and 11 for the Comets.
As the teams both decide what they're trying to do, the clock continues to run. And at this point, it looks like they're just going to run out the clock here. Except for the refs are going to call. And they're going to put a 5-yard penalty on the Comets for a delay of game, which at this point, what's the point? But, oh well. And Cass is going to call a timeout right here at the end of the fourth quarter. I'll be right back with you after it. All right, and we're back for a good 5.4 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And looks like going to be looking for a pass play, maybe. But he's taken down. And that's going to end it for the fourth quarter. Comets win 20-0. Thank you all for watching RTC TV. If you want to, check out our website and our YouTube channel where you'll find all the video and coverage at rtc4.com. Thank you all again for watching. My name is Dakota Hayden, and I will see you all next week.